In this video, I wanted to talk to you about aging with autism. As you are aware, I have been involved in this research project, and tomorrow morning I will be meeting up with a researcher in the Autism CRC based here in Brisbane at the University of Queensland regarding research and awareness of aging with autism. I'd like to make this very clear that the main concern I have as an adult on the autism spectrum is getting older. And of course, the longer term projection is of what it's going to be like, given the fact that I am a single man on the autism spectrum, of what the future is going to be like. Am I going to exist in a home, for example, when I get old and I lose my faculties? And am I likely to be abused and even treated appallingly in an institution? These are the longer term things that we need to think about. And it's not just me that I'm wanting to direct the focus on in this video. I think it's a responsibility for all adults on the autism spectrum, from the ages of 25 onwards, upwards, to really get involved and to have some input into this research. Because, like me, you too are going to get old, and you need to know what is the future going to be like for you and what support and assistance and awareness is going to be available. I would like to make it very clear that for adults on the autism spectrum, that given the high unemployment rate, that many adults are still facing the sense of alienation and segregation in the community. And this is a particularly disturbing trend, because if nothing's being done about it and there's no awareness of it, then what's going to happen to the adults concerned? I think as one gets older, the very concerns, and in my situation, not even owning a house or a home that I can call my own, I wonder what is going to be my future. Where will I be, particularly when, in my given situation, where I'm living with my elderly parents, that, and I know that I can't rely on my siblings to help me because they've got their own lives, what exactly is it going to be like for me in the future? And given the fact that I can only provide a certain amount of support, a certain amount of productivity, which some people may be unaware of just exactly how hard I work, of what is going to be available in the future. So I will be participating in the Aging with Autism research that is being conducted by the Autism CRC. I'm not quite sure, and I don't really support the idea of a brain scan or having a blood test. I do think that people can put their heads together. We have people with our information technology backgrounds, that simply a brain scan can be done surely with computer software and with computer imaging, where simply, I've spoken about this before, where brain activity can be actually harnessed and investigated while cognitive function is occurring. But I would like to say that as I get older, what is the future if in my own situation where my mental functioning deteriorates, is it likely that I could end up in an institution being abused and exploited and not being able to defend or look after myself or to have to deal with inappropriate behaviours? So once again, I leave you with these thoughts, and I really do hope that adults on the autism spectrum do participate in this research, because I'm not in this just for myself, I'm in it also for you. And despite the hard work I do, sometimes I think a lot of you guys are going to really have to lift your act, because a lot of research I'm doing in my spare time, particularly as of late with the survey regarding adults with autism and unemployment and participation in the labour market, there's been a very, very poor response to this. If you guys do not get involved in this, we cannot get the research out there, we cannot get the statistics, and we cannot go to those that can make change and be able to clearly demonstrate the evidence and commitment we have in being able to do something about it. And I know that some of you don't like the fact that I get on your case. That's not the point. The point is we have to work together. We have to start getting our voice heard, and we have to start making more of a voice in the community. Otherwise, we simply are going to be overlooked, and we're never going to have the same rights and support as those of other people. So thanks very much for watching, and please be assured that I will do my best where I can to assist in this aging and autism research. Thank you very much for watching. Oh, and another note, I'd like to also say that I do think that there is a link between parents with autistic offspring and dementia. I do see quite a high statistic of the mothers, particularly of adults on the spectrum, having dementia-like symptoms. I'm sorry, or possibly this occurring. If I offend anybody, I don't mean to. It's just something that I'm tending to sort of notice in it, and possibly more traits of autism being in the fathers. So again, this is something, of course, that needs further investigation, substantiation, and referencing or research. Thanks very much for watching.